are gathered here today before God, our family, and our friends to celebrate one of life's greatest moments, the joining of two hearts. In this ceremony today, we will witness the joining of Matt and Allie in marriage. Who gives this woman to marry this man? I do. For them, nothing about their lives is ordinary. Actually, everything they have gone through is extraordinary. They met through great friends, fell in love, and have built a long-lasting relationship. Today, we celebrate this. This is not just a celebration for you two. Today is a celebration for the rest of us. It is awesome for us to see your love for each other and to be able to participate in the union of two incredible people. At this time, I'd like for us to join in prayer over this couple. Let's bow our heads. Father, we come before you today to solidify this relationship between man and Allie. We ask for your blessing and guidance in everything they do. Be with them, Father, in every step of their marriage, the good, Lord, and the troubling times. We ask for peace over them, knowing you are there with them in every step of their marriage. We thank you in advance, Father, for all the blessings this relationship is going to see. In your Son, Jesus' name, we all pray.
Amen. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
In 1 John 4:16, it says, love is the greatest gift of the world. Another verse says, love between a man and a woman, which matures into marriage, is one of the most beautiful types of love. The fire of love stops at nothing. Floodwaters can't drown love. Torrents of rain can't put it out. Love can't be bought. Love can't be sold. I have some words of wisdom. A good marriage must be created. In marriage, the little things are the big things. It is never being too old to hold hands. It is remembering to say, I love you at least once a day. It is falling asleep next to each other every night. It is standing together and facing the world. It is speaking words of appreciation and demonstrating gratitude in thoughtful ways. It is having the capacity to forgive and forgive. It is giving each other an atmosphere in which each can grow. It is a common search for the good and the beautiful in each other. It is not only marrying the right person, it is being with the right partner throughout your life. Matt and Allie have prepared vows for each other, and they will now read those.
A little over 5 years ago, I was trudging through some of the most challenging times of my life. I really was lost until I found myself inside. You have become my best friend, my love, and my life. I would set my whole world on fire just to watch it burn down in your eyes and have you by my side to rebuild me. I want everyone here to be my dedication. There's some loud shit. And I don't like loud people. But she is my inspiration to wake up every morning. Any residue?
No. Okay, let's try to read with tears in our eyes, shall we? Let's see what this does.
Speaking to the mic. Down on one knee.
I knew the very first time I saw your face at the Halloween because you were going to college, and I was right. You survived a hurricane, a move, a pandemic, and multiple surgeries.
Matt and Allie, I would ask that you always treat each other, always treat yourself and each other with respect, and remind yourselves often of what brought you together today. Give the highest priority the tenderness, gentleness, and kindness that your marriage deserves. When frustration and difficulty hit your marriage, as they do in every relationship at one time or another, Focus on what seems right between you, not only the parties. And if each of you will take responsibility for the quality of your life together, it will be marked by abundance and happiness. Please now, hold hands. Good deal. All right. Matt, do you take Allie, whose hands you hold, choosing her alone to be your wedded wife? Do you promise to love, honor, cherish, and protect her, and be faithful to her?
I do.
And do you promise to love her, even when she's being a teetotal bitch?
I do.
Do you promise to let her get in her nap time every day as scheduled?
Very important.
I will bitch about it, but she'll do it.
Allie, do you take Matt, whose hands you hold, choosing him alone to be your wedded husband? Do you promise to love, honor, cherish, and protect him, and be faithful to him?
I do.
Do you promise not to smack him when he wakes up and interrupts your scheduled nap time?
Don't wake from the
And do you promise to love him in good times and bad, in sickness and health, and honor him at all times, even when he's an asshole?
Every day. I do every day already.
Best you're gonna catch these hands. We're gonna go Polk County real quick.
Matt, if you would get Allie's ring out. While placing the ring on her finger, repeat after me. I promise to be faithful and loving.
I promise to be faithful.
And to put you and our marriage first. I promise to keep your life exciting. On his finger, repeat after me. I promise to not sweat the small stuff. When you game too long, or binge watch a Netflix series for 3 days. To make your relationship work, you take love. This is the core of your marriage and why we are here today. Ephesians 4:2. Always be humble and gentle and patient with each other, making allowances for each other's faults because you love. It will take trust to know that in your hearts you truly want what is best for each other. It will take dedication to stay open to one another and to learn and grow together. It will take faith to go forward together without knowing exactly what the future brings. And it will take commitment to hold true to the journey you both have pledged to today. Now with all that fruit stuff said, it is my absolute honor to now pronounce you husband and wife. Matt, you may kiss your bride.
I now give you for the first time Matt and Allie Davis.
Love it.
Okay, we survived.
Okay, brother.
Woo! All right, we're done. Woo!
No, woo! Into the text.
Dating, I don't know about it. I've been very happy with that.
dance.
I'm going to spin her in. So medicine, right? Sundance.